Chapter 19. Burning Down the Sewing Machine Factory. Fear of change causes people to do bizarre things. A 19th century innovator named Timonier once patented a new machine that he hoped would make army uniforms faster and better. When the news got out, the traditional tailors of France feared for their livelihoods. On the morning of January 20th, 1831, 200 tailors ransacked the new Timonier sewing machine factory in Saint-Étienne. They destroyed the machines, threw the pieces out of the windows, and set the building on fire. The inventor fled for his life. Still, there was no stopping progress. In 1961, Dorothy Vaughn was the supervisor for a team of women computers at the NASA headquarters in South Carolina. Using adding machines, these women worked in teams to solve calculations for the space program. When NASA brought in the first automated IBM computer, Miss Vaughn saw that her team's jobs could be on the line. Instead of throwing the computer out the window, it was pretty heavy after all, she became the department-wide expert on Fortran, the new computer language, and trained her team. NASA moved them to their new positions and gave them raises. They were now responsible for hundreds or even thousands of times more calculations. These women went from replaceable to indispensable. In 2013, a group of distinguished behavior analysts presented a symposium on Gemini to a standing room only crowd at CalABA, the California Conference for BCBAs. Dr. Doug Mose functioned as moderator, and three board certified behavior analysts presented findings in three separate studies. These studies were supported by videos of students, teachers, and therapists who had participated in the trials. The findings were exciting and almost earth-shattering. After the symposium, a line formed out the door and down the hall to sign a request for the PowerPoint presentation. Unbeknownst to the symposium observers, I sat in the back of the room and watched. I had never seen that kind of attention or interest in a BCBA conference. The room was packed and positively electric. No one knew me by sight, and they didn't know that Gemini was created by a mother who was not formally trained as a therapist. I stood outside the door and listened to people as they walked outside the conference. All the discussion had one theme. This is so good. Are we going to be out of a job? Hardly. If everyone in the U.S. were given the amount of speech or behavior therapy they truly needed to make optimal improvements, we would need over 5 million therapists. In reality, we have fewer than 150,000 speech pathologists and fewer than 50,000 behavior analysts. We aren't even close to filling the need. Each year, U.S. school districts battle to hire new speech and language pathologists, SLPs, to serve the ever-growing population of children with special needs. The demand is growing almost exponentially, despite the criteria for approval for speech services becoming more and more narrow. Talk to a speech pathologist who worked with children in the 1970s or before, and they will tell you they primarily worked on articulation. I knew an SLP who came out of retirement to help the dire situation that many districts find themselves. She was shocked at the level of severity of her caseload. Another SLP told me that she goes home in tears from work because she knows that she could help her kiddos if she had more time with them. But with the 30 minutes per week that she is allotted, she just isn't getting anywhere. Gemini allows all the children in school to get the hours they need. It lets the districts treat the increasing caseload with their current staff. Children with articulation needs can be triaged to Gemini in their pull-out sessions, freeing up more in vivo time for severely affected children. It generates therapy homework that encourages and trains parents to participate more in their children's therapy routine. It also teaches non-English speaking parents a common language with their own children, as the videos are accessed by the entire family. Jamie Cutting, an SLP who has witnessed firsthand the difference Gemini can make, writes, "Hi, I'm a speech therapist in Clark County School District in Las Vegas. I paid for a Gemini account out of my own pocket for a sweet 4-year-old student I service. He had been receiving 2 hours of ABA before school, 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. Then he goes to an autism preschool program in the district where I provide 240 minutes of speech therapy a week. And he was still making little to no progress. I was literally crying myself to sleep over this little guy. I stumbled upon Gemini on Facebook and said, "What have I got to lose except for $100? So it's been 2 weeks and he is spontaneously pointing, imitating the animal actions, and even some of the animal sounds. I'm beyond excited. I want this for every student. Our district needs this. Our kids need this. Thank you for this program. Thank you." Jamie Cutting, MACCCSLP. Globally, the numbers for trained therapists are even bleaker. People in the UK will sometimes comment that they are fortunate as they have healthcare paid for by their government. The reality is that children in the UK are lucky to get 2 hours of therapy a week. And unless they pay privately, no one is getting 40 hours per week. In many areas of the world, including the United States, it is even worse. It needs to be made clear to all parents of autistic children that there is no research with live therapy anywhere that says that less than 25 hours of therapy per week can make a significant difference with a child with autism. Although anecdotal reports from our Gemini community are saying that children are making significant improvements with just an hour per day of video viewing, these families are generalizing the video curriculum for several more hours each day, and by doing so, distracting the child from the pull of his inner world. A fully funded and operational 40-hour-per-week therapy program in the U.S. costs roughly $120,000 per year. This one child will completely monopolize the time of a therapist, as well as take many hours per month away from several others. Leveraging time and money through the Gemini platform, a therapist can now serve up to 260 students, with each of those students achieving greater gains at a cost of a small fraction of the alternative. And this therapist can treat a child anywhere in the world. Trained specialists' time can be leveraged another way, through time zone change. The after-school hours of 3 to 7 are maxed out in nearly every city in the U.S., allowing therapists to oversee clients in different time zones opens up a huge pool of available therapists. Lower cost and more prevalent respite workers can take the place of highly trained specialists in places where there are no specialists. Specialists can now oversee large numbers of respite workers through teletherapy and reviewing a client's Gemini account. This change must happen because the status quo is unacceptable. Tell me, is it at all fair that a small, fortunate few receive 40 hours of therapy when so many get so little? And considering this cost saving and greater efficacy, do you think that insurance will continue as status quo? Gemini is in discussions with insurance companies even now. Automation is coming. For the good of the children, it must come. Those who embrace it will reap the benefits, both personally, as they will help so many more children, and professionally, as they will earn so much more money doing so. Those in the field who don't will end up like a CPA with a 10 key in a Microsoft Excel world. Just today, I received the kind of message that I'm seeing more and more often. Marie Basic writes, "I run a respite agency with over 600 families in San Diego. Many of them pay much more out of pocket for speech therapy than the cost of Gemini, and speech therapy hasn't done much all these years. We have seen more success with Gemini than with paying out of pocket for SLP, so we discontinued SLP and focused on Gemini. I wanted to try it first with my own child before recommending it to them, and I am sold now." My heart sinks every time I read something like this, because I know how valuable a therapist's knowledge is when combined with the power of Gemini. We see the fastest gains and the biggest miracles when the two work hand in hand. I wish I could sit down with every speech pathologist in the world and explain to them the opportunity they have and the danger they face if they don't modernize. I want to partner with them. I want to offer training with Gemini and be able to refer the thousands of parents who are searching for a professional help with their Gemini program. To prove my point, after Marie Bassick read this chapter to approve her quote, this is what she wrote back. Hi, Laura. I didn't know you could combine Gemini and speech therapy. I am extremely interested in learning more. I would love to help connect you with SLPs that are active in our community. Let me know what you think. Kids need 25 hours at a minimum of therapy per week. I am certainly not saying that I have all the answers, but with the brilliant people in this industry, no one has come up with a solution to serve this ever-increasing population. If they have and I missed it, I'm all ears. Upon writing this, the designer Hubert de Givenchy has recently passed away. Would he have soared to the zenith of fashion without the sewing machine? Would Christian Dior or Ralph Lauren? Much like the early days of the fashion industry, we are striking out in a new era of therapy. Gemini makes all this possible. The platform even allows therapists to brand and sell their own type of specialized technique. It allows for followers of these new techniques to be trained in the tens of thousands or even hundreds of thousands. It allows for children all over the world to experience the unique insights to complex situations that the therapist has developed. And it does all of this without the need of technical training or capital. All one needs is a login, a password, and a phone with a camera. There are therapists who have already started down this road using Gemini. Their practices are booming, and they are demanding higher fees than any therapists I know. They can charge per issue rather than per hour. The parents pay less overall, but get more. For instance, just how much would you pay for your adult child to be toilet trained? The time has come where one can do very well by doing good, and do good for millions instead of just a few. Who will be the icons of artistry and therapy in the years to come?